bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Fine light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, you and I. We're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see. A vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky.
If you want to know the power that girls have, check Miss Fenty. My girl, her thing turn up subtle. A little girl from a little country right here in the little Caribbean is so established now with her own talent and her work ethic that she's turned around and helping the US to sort out them COVID drama by donating stuff to New York. That's what girls can do if not inhibited. We're not saying give any free passes to anybody. We're saying move the obstacles out of the way, and whoever wants to shine can shine. And that's what this story is all about today. That said, let me step out of the way, because Latifah Pusey is a shining star who's going to jump in now and weigh in on our discussion. We're talking girls in ICT, in the age of technology, where's the girl child? Bridget Lewis is here. She and her partner, Nicole Peter Patterson. How's Nicole, by the way, Bridget? She's all right?
She is good. She is in, as you know, she's in Switzerland.
Right, that's right. I forgot.
Yes, so she's she's probably been up since maybe 3 a.m. this morning working on all sorts of deliverables that we have to put in place. I have to tell you that, I mean, if anybody thinks planning a virtual event is easier than a physical event, think again. Oh my goodness.
Your backups have to have backups for your backups.
Trust me, and everything. Yes. You know, on the day, you know, when you have a physical event, you can get a banner from a sponsor like the day before and just stick it in the hall.
Right.
No way. Everything has got to be set from way before because it's an app.
That's right.
Right? It's just been crazy, but we've just had such a great experience. I mean, we feed off the energy of the girls who are engaged in this hackathon.
Well, when it works,
as much as they talk about, you know, how much of a wonderful experience it is for them, we could not do this without feeding it from their energy. So we are just thrilled to be a part of their orbit.
Wonderful. You know?
We really are.
So. Good. Latifa Pusey, we want to feel your energy now, sister. Little sister, your time. You want to weigh in, please?
Okay, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Latifa.
Latifa Pusey, and I would like to direct my questions. Which is, how is the
where are you located now? We're getting an odd kind of sound. Is that more like a feedback or something? What is it? You want to shift around just that little bit? It's really noisy.
Okay, can you hear me better now?
We're hearing you, but there's a grating kind of noise. I'm not sure what it is. All right. Somebody else wants to hop in just a little bit while Latifa kind of maybe moves around a little bit so we can get that background a little clearer. All right. While we do that, maybe I should just jump in and ask Destiny. You heard what your colleagues were saying about their own designs on shining. And we played two of the songs we played so far are from people from Barbados, right? So you have the article Lady Prime Minister. So do you feel that that kind of example around you kind of gives you the power? When you look and you see Ariana Fenty, some little girl who's now powerful globally, when you see the rising stars like the musicians, when you see your prime minister, when you look into your own home and see your mommy, how do examples help you to soar, Destiny?
Well, just like you were saying, I have so many examples around me that I am 100% grateful for. It is one thing I would say is all of my role models are women, because it is crazy to see what we can do in so many different aspects of life. So as you were saying, see how Rihanna was a little girl. I'm not even sure she dreamt about where she would be today, but where she is now is just phenomenal. It is amazing that I'm at an age now where I can witness our first female prime minister. And that just says a lot, because it shows where we have come from. So I would say just these amazing examples around me, even my mother as well, even these examples around me prove to me every day that I can do anything. That is why when earlier, I think Donato was asking about being optimistic for the future. Yes, I am. Because when I said, I don't know if Rihanna even thought she would be here today, but she was optimistic. So me know her not having the examples that I have personally, but the ones that I have now, I am more than optimistic for the future, and they play a great role in helping me to showcase in so many different ways how I shine. So I am so proud to be surrounded by the kind of people that I am right now, especially these amazing role models.
What has the hackathon taught you so far?
Well, the hackathon has taught me how to lead in a different way. Because before, I love to always say I'm a natural born leader. So I have led before, but not in this kind of way. And it is just very, very nice. So it helps me with my leadership skills. It helps me to develop my technology skills in so many different ways, whether that is learning how to build a website, develop an app, come up with a storyboard for our animation. Like, it has helped me in so many different ways. And it has helped me even more to be more, I would say, social and outspoken, because I would tell so many different people I'm a little antisocial sometimes, but the hackathon has helped me with that. I have actually participated in the hackathon before in 2019, and that one was in person. So we spent the day working around us with so many different people, and that was new for me because, as I said, I'm a little antisocial. So just being around people like that and having the girls from so many different schools in my country that I have never met before has helped me so much with my social skills, has helped me so much with my team building skills. It has just helped me so in so many different areas, honestly, that I can't even name all of them.
Wow, that's really very, very encouraging to hear. Did you ever ask your parents why they called you Destiny? I just think it's a very powerful name. I know at least two more people named Destiny, and believe me, they one is quiet and one is sometimes, you know. Maybe you're sure you're antisocial, or it's just a situation of being introverted. I mean, introverts, we live in an extroverted world, but I'm an introvert, but I'm doing this kind of thing that makes me seem like an extrovert because it matters.
Right.
So when something matters, you find your mojo and you're shot. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, maybe when we're quiet, people think we're antisocial, but you're not inspired to kind of move at a certain pace when you're not inspired, you know? Maybe that's it.
Right, that is so. What you just said is a perfect explanation because I feel what you feel when you said that you're a little bit introverted, but when you have a passion, when you have a drive, it's so amazing to see this different person unfold in front of your eyes. Mm-hmm. So I completely agree with what you just said.
Yes.
And in terms of what they name me destiny, I keep asking them. I ask them so all the time because I'm a very inquisitive kid. So it's a whole long story about why they did that. But my parents, especially my mother, she's very, very spiritual. So I feel like she always knew in her heart that I wasn't just, you know, a normal kid. I was just different in so many ways. So I feel my name has a lot behind it. And God willing, I will have my patience and I will wait to see what he has for me and what my name really means in the future, including right now.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Self-fulfilling prophecy in a good way, you know. You have this label. I mean, naming is important, very, very important. Thanks, Destiny. We're going to have to take a little break. And when we come back, we go once again. Everybody just give some nice power and some love to Latifa. She's going to try again. Just give her hands up and all these things so that she feels vibes for come back.
Develop a quality workforce of professionals with state-of-the-art medical training through affordable pre-med and MD programs at Caribbean School of Medical Sciences, Jamaica. The time by Caribbean School of Medical Sciences, Jamaica is
2:15.
Tune in to Cygnus Tax 101 and stay in the know on tax planning opportunities for companies, finance managers, directors, and entrepreneurs with tax expert Denzin White, Vice President and Head of Tax Advisory at Cygnus Group, during the hotline on alternate Mondays at 10:15 a.m. That's Cygnus Tax 101, brought to you by Cygnus Tax Advisory Limited, one of the Caribbean's leading full-service tax solutions firm, a member of the Cygnus Group of Companies.
It's current, informative, educational, and it deals with the issues. It's Teacher's Time.
Come up in Teacher's Stand, Sunday, May 2. Join us for another in the series, Conversation with our JTE President, Jasper Gabriel. Hear him continue to speak to the challenges you face as teachers, among them salaries and conditions of service. So take this as your invitation to listen to Teacher's Stand, Sunday, May 2 at 4:30 p.m. on Your Radio Jamaica 94 FM. Teacher's Time, 50 minutes of timely and relevant information for your consideration.
Teacher's Time, brought to you by the Jamaica Teachers Association, Unite and Serve, and the JTA Cooperative Credit Union Limited, serving our members, impacting lives positively.
The voice of the nation is Radio Jamaica.
Yeah, we just kind of clipped a little piece out of that because it was giving us a nice pumped up energy. So it's all about girl power today, and we're talking girls in tech. Our main guest in studio right now, virtual studio, is Bridget Lewis from SheLeadsIT. And guess who's back? Latifa. Latifa, you want to try again for me? Let's see how it goes.
Good afternoon. Can you guys hear me now?
Significantly better. God bless your heart. Go ahead.
Thank you. This question is directed to Miss Bridget.
I would like to ask how the competition is going so far versus when it had initially started. What is the update like?
Hi,
Sorry, Latifa. Can you just repeat the tail end of what you just said? I didn't hear you.
Okay, I'm sorry about that. I was asking how the competition is going thus far versus when it had initially started.
Oh, well, it ended actually last week. Last weekend, we had our final judging. So we do not know who has won the competition, which team won, and neither do any of the girls who are on the program this at this time. So we ended on the weekend with the final judging, and it was amazing. I cannot tell you more than you have to look at, watch out on our social media platforms, SeaGirlsHack_ on Instagram, SeaGirlsHack on Twitter, and Caribbean Girls Hack on Facebook. Keep checking for the link to join us on Saturday, May 8th. That's where you're going to see everything that these girls have worked so hard on for the last 8 to 10 weeks. They've been in workshops with various subject matter experts, sensitizing around our topics, gender-based violence, climate change and sustainability, save our oceans, using modalities like animation, documentary and short film, photo storyboarding, music video, vlogging. So lots and lots to share with you, but it has been an amazing journey. I don't know if the girls want to talk more about that, but for us, we were literally knocked off our feet when we saw some of the solutions that the teams came up with. So we're really, really pleased and all excited to unveil the winners on Saturday, May 8th.
In the Twitter and IG handles is with a Z, right?
Yes, SeaGirlz with a Z, hack_, that's for IG, and SeaGirlz with a Z, hack, Twitter, and Caribbean Girls with an S, hack, for Facebook.
All right, great. Does that do it for you, Latifa? You got what you needed there?
Yes, thank you so much.
And thanks for persevering, Latifa. It shows that you're a champion. Champions don't give up. So we're glad that you stuck with it. So glad. All right. Donato, you had another one you wanted to ask?
Yes, and I want to throw this one out to... Well, anybody can answer it. I was actually very shocked to hear the numbers earlier when Miss Bridget opened the segment. Just from what I see, I really thought that girls in ICT participation was a lot higher. I just want to know what you guys think it is that's hindering the participation from women and girls. My niece, she's 12 years old, but she is great at TikTok. I mean, she's doing those little things better than I could ever do it. But if you ask her what she wants to be when she grows up, she's going to say she wants to be a nurse. No problem with that, by the way. But I just really want to know what you guys think it is, in your opinion, that's causing women and girls to shy away from joining the ICT field.
That's a good one. Siobhana, you want to take that or Bernadine? Why do girls shy away from the ICT field, do you think? Bernadine, your hand is up. Go ahead.
No problem. To answer your question, I think one of the issues that girls shy away from it is cultural brought up scene. How we were grown, how we were taught. So it's kind of like girls not feeling comfortable in the field because it's not something that society sees as normal, that where a girl should pursue. So they would like to think on cultural differences, right? They would say girls ought to be housewives, how to cook, clean, those kind of stuff, and can't actually pursue their dreams. However, the world is changing. So I will tell any girl out there, if you want to pursue anything in ICT, go right ahead, because, I mean, at the end of the day, you have to do what you feel comfortable doing. And if you are into TikToks, this is also a great way to get your videos better, because through the hackathon, you are learning about video editing, you're learning how to hold the camera, you're learning to edit the videos in a way that showcases the message you want to get across. So I think that may be one of the main reasons, but there are also other stuff, if that answers your question.
Does that do it, Danasa? Yes? I guess he's not with us then. One of the things you just said a while ago, Bernadine, that really resonated with me is when you talked about you being able to do editing. It's enough, I mean, in other words, girls could be populating and representing more, but without that final frontier, which is digital storytelling, is in the editing. So you can have the input, somebody tells a story, you can have lovely pictures, you can have images, but what if at the end of the day you hand it over to somebody to edit and their editing has a point of view? So with 51% of the world's point of view missing, it's going to lack something. So that's awesome that you're getting that you know, that final thing. Editing is very, very tedious, but it determines the product. And you can have pretty good material and it doesn't resonate because it edited with another perspective. You know that old African proverb, it's different in all every part of the African nations within them. But the essence is the same, that as long as whichever animal you use, some say tiger, some say lion, as long as they're not telling the story, then the story is going to be the hunter's story. So it's going to be how brave the hunter is, as opposed to how mercenary. If you ask the lion, the hunter is mercenary. If you ask the hunter is brave, right? So that was a great eye-opener and a good one there, Bernadine. Thank you so much for that indeed. We just have a couple of minutes left in this segment. Anybody else wants to get any questions in? If not immediately, Bridget, I'd like you to tell us a little bit about Girls in ICT Day and maybe throw something out there for anybody who wants to catch it next time. Hi, Bridget.
Yes.
I think you're muted again.
Sorry.
All right, yes, go ahead.
No, I was just waiting to hear if anybody else wanted to jump in.
Yeah. No, I'll acknowledge them. Just go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, yes, so Girls in ICT Day is celebrated internationally every year, which is the fourth Thursday in April. So fourth Thursday in April every year, Girls in ICT Day is celebrated. It's an initiative under the umbrella of the International Telecoms Union in Switzerland, more specifically one of their sub-entities, Equals. They have responsibility for that particular initiative, and it happens every year. And it's a day when the focus and the spotlight is on girls and girls engaging in ICT in ways that they probably never thought possible. So our hackathon, even though it did not happen on the 24th, is a part of the Girls in ICT Day celebration. So we're having it on, the final event is on May 8th, but as I said, the girls have been engaged for the past 10 weeks. And so it's considered a Girls in ICT Day celebration event. When you walk in, virtually walk into the space, you'll see the Girls in ICT Day banners, and the entire program is all around empowerment of girls in ICT.
Wonderful. Thank you for the fantastic work that you do along with your team and with Nicole, Bridget.
Jerry, I just wanted to say that we have a fantastic tech partner in Trinidad.
Yes.
And since this is a Caribbean initiative, we wanted to just big up our tech partners in Trinidad, Restore a Sense of I Can, RSC Tech Clubs with Raj Ramdas. We could not do it without them. And we just want to say thank you to our sponsors, one of which is Flow. I hear them coming through on the ads.
Yes.
As well as the Canada Fund, and the IDB, Inter-American Development Bank.
Lots of people do a lot of talking. So when they actually put the foot forward, we have to load them up.
Yeah, and we have sponsors like NCB that they've really been with us throughout. We have Digicel. We have Fujitsu. So the tech companies are really standing up and saying, hey, we want to be a part of this movement because it's a movement.
All right. So whether you're able to do any more, we have to ease out of this segment now. But remember, Girlz Hack on Twitter with a Z, Girlz Hack _ again with a Z on IG, and Caribbean Girls Hack with a regular S. Thank you very much, Bridget, and give my best regards to the team. These girls are on fire. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, Destiny. Thank you, Shavona. Thank you, Bernadine. You're going to do well regardless of the final placing. You're already representing yourself very, very well. Let's get out of here in a blaze of glory with Alicia Keys.